Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Penguin Exhibit. My name is Brenden. I'm a staff member here with the Penguin Colony. Many of you tuned in to our last virtual tour, where we explained a little bit about one of their seasons, which is their molting season. Today I'm going to talk to you guys about another of their seasons, which is their nesting season. If you've been watching our live stream, you may have noticed some of our courting behaviors that our birds have been displaying, one of which is a pair bonding motion where they both will bow their heads and call to each other. Another is an ecstatic display where they reach their head up to the sky and call out for their mates, trying to attract mates or establishing their territories. Penguins are generally able to mate once they have gone through their first catastrophic molt. That happens after the first 18 to 24 months of their life. Females are generally able to reproduce at ages between 4 and 16. And some have even been able to reproduce as old as 32 years old. Here at the New England Aquarium, we have two species of penguins, our African penguins and our southern rockhopper penguins. On the live stream, you're seeing the African penguins. And these guys actually have two different types of nesting behaviors. So these guys, the African penguins, will actually burrow into the guano around where they are, or into the land itself. While our southern rockhopper penguins will actually make nests on top of the surface of the land. Here at the New England Aquarium, we participate in something called the Species Survival Plan. The Species Survival Plan basically recommends who we should mate with who, based on their genetics. That way we can ensure that we have as diverse a genetic population as possible. Sometimes that means that we will actually trade penguins with other zoos and aquariums to keep the genetic pool as diverse as possible for future years to come. Once we have an SSP approved pair, we'll actually take them behind the scenes, give them a cave and nesting material so they can begin to pair bond and prepare for breeding season. Most penguin species lay a clutch of 2 eggs, apart from the king and emperor penguins who lay 1 egg each. They'll actually incubate those eggs, depending on the species, for about 40 days until they actually hatch. So we leave the chicks with their parents to care for them till they're about a month to a month and a half old. So the parents will actually rear them, regurgitating food for them. Sometimes the parents can't meet the demands of the chicks, so we actually have to step in and take over for the parents. But once they are a month to a month and a half old, we will take over, start feeding them fish whole, so that they can get used to life here on exhibit. Here at the New England Aquarium, actually last year, we were able to successfully raise 4 chicks, one of which being Sea Cat. Once she got to a certain weight, her parents were no longer able to meet the demands of a growing chick, so we actually stepped in and started to hand rear her a little early. As you can see, she is perfectly healthy and happy here on exhibit. In addition to Sea Cat, we had 3 African penguins hatch here at the New England Aquarium last year on May 8th, 14th, and 18th. So their 1-year birthdays are coming up. Sea Cat's birthday was last year, June 6th, so we'll wish her a happy birthday. And just a little bit. So unfortunately, 13 out of the 18 species of penguins in the world are either threatened or endangered in the wild. This is due to a number of factors, including overfishing. When we take out more fish than the oceans can reproduce on their own, it means that penguins... have less fish to feed themselves and to feed their chicks. So chick mortality rates are rising. A way you can fix this at home, if you like seafood, just make sure that you're buying seafood that's caught in a sustainable way or that's farm raised, so it's not impacting these guys and other creatures of the ocean. So once again, my name is Brenden. I hope you guys learned a little something about penguins today and their breeding habits. Stay tuned tomorrow at 11 a.m. Will be another virtual tour. But until then, hope you all have a wonderful day. Thank you.